Welcome to the Fit Small Business Zero Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to create and manage expense claims in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. If an employee or business owner spends personal funds to purchase items for their business, they must complete an expense claim to be reimbursed. Expense claims are similar to expense reports in that you can submit multiple receipts on one expense claim. For example, if you attended a conference and you used your personal credit card to pay for airfare, rental car, and hotel, you can submit receipts for all of these items on one expense claim to request reimbursement. While traditionally expense claims would be submitted by paper and processed by hand, Xero lets you create reports within the software and attach receipts digitally. Then Xero handles all the accounting for you. To create an expense claim in Xero, click on Accounts and then click on Expense Claims. In the next screen, we're going to go ahead and click on the Add Receipt button. And here are the fields of information that must be completed for an expense claim. In the Receipt From field, you want to enter the name of the company as it appears on your receipt. You want to go ahead and select the date for the transaction. The reference field is optional. You may include any additional information in this field regarding this purchase. In the description field, you want to enter the business purpose for this expense. If you purchased items, you can enter the quantity purchased in this field here. In the unit cost field here, you want to go ahead and enter the amount of the purchase here. From the drop-down in the account field, you want to select the account that the purchase should be categorized to. Please note, if an account has not been flagged to show in expense claims, it will not show up in the drop-down. To make this change, you will need to go to the chart of accounts and add the flag to the account. You can click here to learn more about how the chart of accounts works. From the drop-down of the tax rate field, you want to select the appropriate tax rate if applicable, or leave the default rate of 0% if there is no tax rate. In the tax rate lesson, we walk through how to set up tax rates. Click here to access this lesson. Tracking category. If you use tracking categories such as region, as in this example, then go ahead and select the appropriate tracking category from the drop-down here. In the upper right-hand corner, this icon represents Attach. You can attach copies of receipts and other supporting documentation to this expense claim. You can also add additional lines if you need to by clicking this link here. Here at the bottom, you have an option to save and add another receipt. You can select this option if you have multiple receipts that you need to enter. Please note that the expenses do not have to be related for you to select this option. In the next step, we will show you how to submit receipts for approval and the Save button. Once you have completed all of the fields, you can click the Save button. You can also save even if you have not completed all of the fields and come back later to complete them. Xero will not allow you to actually submit a receipt for reimbursement until all fields have been completed. So we'll go ahead and save this. You should see a confirmation here up at the top that the receipt was actually saved. So all the receipts that you have added in expense claims will appear in this screen. Receipts that have not been submitted for approval will appear here on the Current Claim tab. The total number of receipts along with the total amount will appear over here to the right. So as you can see, we've got three receipts that total $870 in this example. So next, we want to go ahead and select the receipts that we'd like to go ahead and submit for approval. You can either click this box here at the very top of the column to select all, or you could select individual receipts and submit them that way. Once you've made all your selections, you can simply click the button that says Submit for Approval. And this is just our confirmation, so we'll click OK. Yes, we want to go ahead and submit those for approval. All expense claims that have been submitted but not authorized for payment will appear in the Awaiting Authorization tab here. Once the expense claim has been approved, it will move over to the Awaiting Payment tab. If you have an advisor role, then you can approve, decline, or delete your own expense claims as well as other employees. Click here to learn more about user permissions. Now let's walk through how to approve, decline, or delete expense claims. So we'll return back to the Expense Claims tab, like we did at the beginning, by clicking on Accounts and Expense Claims. And then let's go ahead and click on Awaiting Authorizations. And then we'll click on the row that shows our expense claim that we just entered. So these are the receipts that we have waiting for approval. First of all, to take action on any of these items, you can click the checkbox here to select all of them or make individual selections here. Click the Approve button to authorize payment for individual receipts or the entire claim. You can click the Decline button to decline payment for individual receipts or the entire claim. A notification will be sent to the person that submitted the claim to let them know that it has been declined. You can also delete a receipt that you do not wish to pay. A notification will also be sent to the person that submitted the claim, letting them know that you have deleted the claim. Approve total down here. Based on your selection, Xero will automatically calculate the total amount of the claim that you have approved. We've got a delete expense claim button here that allows you to delete the entire claim, which again will send a notification to the person who submitted the claim. And then to the left of the Delete Expense Claim button, we've got a View Expense Claim Summary Report. This is actually an aging report for all expense claims. It will show you all of the unpaid expense claims and the number of days they have been outstanding or unpaid. Here is an example of an expense claim summary report for our fictitious company, Acme Web Pros Plus. So we'll go ahead and approve this expense claim. Once you have approved an expense claim, you can immediately authorize it for payment. If you scroll down, there's a section here you'll see called Authorize Expense Claim. So we can go ahead and indicate the payment due date, when we would like the claim to be paid, and indicate the reporting date, which can be the same date or a different date. And then we can go ahead and click the blue button when we are ready to authorize the payment. Please note that after payment has been authorized, you can pay the expense claim by check. To learn more about this, click this link. If you manage your payroll in Xero, you can also reimburse an employee's expense claim using payroll. Click the link below for more information on how to do this. So we'll go ahead and authorize this for payment. And we've got our notification showing us that expense claim has been authorized for payment. That wraps up the lesson on how to create and manage expense claims in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.